Welcome to Blush Talks. We're here at Blushington Makeup and Beauty Lounge on the Upper East Side with an amazing guest today, Darcy Miller.
Hi. Thank you for having me.
We're so excited to
have
you.
Thank you for beautifying me. That's a big help.
Well, you gave us a gorgeous canvas. And before we jump into Darcy's amazing story, I just want to tell you how grateful we are, the women of Blushington, for the welcome you gave us in New York City.
And it was fun, and you know, always happy to celebrate you, you know, entrepreneur, female entrepreneur, and great business.
Well, it was so appreciated. We'll never forget it. And for everyone at home, as you see friends and women starting businesses, the support means the world to everyone that's out there grinding every day. And some people talk about supporting one another, and others do. So we're really, really appreciative, Darcy.
Oh, well, I'm happy. And I would say that in terms of the support is, of course, I'm happy to support you and anyone, you know, great who's starting a business. But it's also a service to our friends to share Blushington and being in the wedding industry for years and years. Like, it's important for me to let other, you know, planners and other ones and people in our industry know about Blushington as a great service.
Well, thanks for letting them in on the secret. And we're here really to discuss an extraordinary career with so many exciting stops on the way.
And says
so
my much mother.
So much to come.
Meet my new publicist.
My lap is, you know, weighed down by all of the successes here. But let's start with your unbelievable book, Celebrate Everything. It is the most joyous and I would say useful read that I've had since I can't remember when. So maybe we'll rewind a little.
Right.
Tell us how you developed this love for craft and making life beautiful, and then maybe we can talk a little bit more about this journey.
Great. Well, I have always loved celebrating and crafting, and it's something I grew up in New York City and was always doing creative projects with my mom when I was like in seventh grade. My mom used to take me to the bead store, and I would make earrings, and actually I took the actual place card for my bat mitzvah and used them as the board for earrings, and then I would put them in Ziploc bags and sell them to the store on 83rd and Madison called Stone Free for Kids. And so
reuse of a place card.
Exactly. And the funny thing is the other day I found some extra ones. They were a little photo of me when I was little. I was like, oh my gosh, hoarder, how do I still have place cards for my bat mitzvah? That explains why our apartment looks the way it does.
Well, it looks pretty immaculate to me.
I don't know,
pictures.
You don't open the closets with the stuff pouring out.
So this started in your childhood.
Yes.
Love for beauty.
And my mom is super creative and always makes, you know, everything special. And I would say that, you know, the book is packed with a ton of ideas. But for me, you know, what the soul is like, you know, that extra detail to celebrate people, to take time to appreciate, you know, the happy moments in life. And there's a page in the beginning of the book that's like all the things to celebrate. And it's obviously the big occasions, but then also, you know, the half birthdays and the retirement.
Absolutely.
And a clean bill of health and the other things that there's always something to celebrate. And
I'm with you. I think that if life gets hectic and crazy, and it's sometimes even celebrating the smallest joys or victories that make those lasting memories.
Definitely. And so the other day, actually, my niece was visiting and staying with my parents, and my mother had decorated the dinner table. She was going off to camp. And
so
I was like,
sweet.
Okay, see? It's, you know, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. And I think that the book, hopefully for me, is useful to other people for jumping off points. And some of the stuff is just, you know, a cross stick puzzle. So if, you know, for Martha's birthday, I threw a dinner party for her 70th. Last year.
So just for everyone at home, because they may not know about this amazing relationship and friendship, Darcy has worked with Martha Stewart for
26 years.
So
yes,
this
I started when I was four.
This was a special birthday for Martha Stewart.
Exactly.
So how do you impress Martha
Exactly. That is, and I always say, I actually did a segment on the Martha Show about this, and I said to her, which is true, like, I was like, oh, it's your birthday, I want to do something for you, because I always love throwing I actually like throwing parties for everyone else, not, I hate my own birthday. Everyone at the office knows that I actually never go to work on my birthday, because there's nothing I like, okay, worse than like going into a conference room and everyone will be like, happy birthday. Like, I don't like, I used to hide under the birthday, under the table on my birthday.
You're busy
birthday.
Celebrating everyone
so,
else.
So, I offered to have a dinner for her, and then we kind of never talked about it, like, maybe 2 weeks before. Her system was like, oh yeah, no, I have Thursday night on the calendar for your dinner. I was like, oh my god, I better get going. And I have to say,
no pressure.
That, exactly, no pressure. How do you throw a birthday party for Martha Stewart? But after all the years, and I've obviously learned so much from her, from all the incredible people in the industry, from my mother, from everyone, and I've been to a lot of incredible events, but after all of this, really what made that party great is that it was really personal, and it was a small group of us who grew up together working, you know, with Martha, and
so much history.
And it was so personal, and so she loves lemons, so we served the drinks, lemons, and Peter Callahan, I don't know if you know Callahan Catering.
Yes.
He actually has a new book about to come out, have to get it, but we always collaborate, and always start with, you know, whoever we're celebrating, and so, you know, she loves Scrabble, so Ron Ben Israel made me petty fours that spelled out happy birthday, Martha, and
so
actually she
fabulous.
Wrote the foreword for the book. I can see if I can share it.
We'd love
way.
To see that. So it's all in the thoughtful details.
Right, it's not in, oh, so here it is, it's kind of, not sure.
So here are the lemons.
But
so
the lemons.
You cut a lemon in half, you scoop it out, and
right.
You serve the drink.
Exactly.
No leaking, no...
Well, the diner was looking okay right
okay.
now, but...
All right,
you
so
know,
this
oh,
is a great tip for summer.
Letter, petty fours, and then I did coasters with pictures of her. And
that's such a clever idea. How
and
did you
something
do that?
Just, you know, you send away to... you. I mean, there's so many
choices.
There's so
online.
Many great online resources today, and in the back of the book, I also have a list of where everything is from. But you know, going back to this dinner and kind of what everything I learned, and, which is that, you know, it's not about the number of flowers that are on the table. It's really about them having the people you love, and it's that little detail. I have to say that we did a funny game, which is called a crossed puzzle, where we I gave everyone a paper that said Martha, you know, her name,
right,
and everyone had to write words to describe her, you know, M is for marvelous, A, and it was so
fabulous.
Funny, and then we went around the table reading them, we're like, okay, who said that, and you know, and it's sometimes, you know, it's the one of the quotes in the book is, it's the things that cost the least that matter the most.
So I was just going to touch on that. It sounds, I mean, there's so much beauty in what you do, but I think one of the great elements is how accessible you make
right.
these ideas.
I mean, not
that
to say that I don't have 50 pounds of candy and 700 decorated, personalized party things that I've ordered online. So I'm not preaching that I, you know, don't buy anything for the parties, but I think
but
the soul of it
the thoughtfulness.
Is the personalization, and it's I always talk about one of my favorite games on New Year's Eve is when everyone writes their resolutions, and then we collect them and read them and guess whose they are, and inevitably there's someone who writes, you know, I have to be a better husband, and then we have to guess who it is, and you know, everyone's pointing their finger to, you know, their husband. But
these are such great ideas
right.
that create memories and make such a lasting impression.
Yes.
I love the lemons. I love the Scrabble cookies. I'm impressed that you took on hosting for Martha.
Well, you know, Martha's been such an incredible inspiration, but also you have to remember that I've literally worked for her for over 25 years. So, you know, when I started at Martha Stewart, it was still a startup. Part of time, and there was a small handful of us. So
what
my
was your
job was to
first job, Darcy.
I was
Martha Stewart,
an editorial assistant, but that meant answering the phones, getting coffee, ordering sodas. I mean, you name it. You know, pulling clothes for the Today Show, dyeing Easter eggs.
So I'm just going to pause here. So here we are sitting with this incredible body of work from Darcy and this extraordinary magazine, Martha Stewart Weddings, which we love here at Blushington. It's our Bible,
right.
And we'll get to. But it started with answering phones and getting coffee. And that's just a great reminder to all of us that it's not where you start, it's a journey. And anything is possible when you put effort, creativity, hard work, and I mean.
Right. And I think that that's part of any, and you, I'm sure, are the same way, but you know, kind of everyone does everything. And still, I remember one of the first shoots I went to with Martha, we were at the Sempini firm in Illinois, and we were doing an early shoot and a cover shoot, and then we were scrambling, and then we were scrambling to get on this plane, and we're packing. I'm like, no, I'll pack up the ball jars, don't worry. She said, no, give me the bubble, you know, and it's just
she set that tone.
The way, you know, it is. And I think that you know, it's important to also to have a good time while you're doing it.
Absolutely. I think we have a saying here, we start every phone call with a little bit of a giggle, because
right.
There's so much to handle, problems to solve, exciting things to plan, but you have to have a sense of humor
right.
along the way.
Well, I think also, especially being in the wedding business, and you know, one of the things I feel really lucky about in my career are all the incredible women and people in general who, I want to just say women, Anthony, Lucia, who has worked with me for years at Martha Stewart, who's, you know, my work husband.
It's good to have one of those.
You know, we finish each other's sentences. But I think that, you know, being around interesting, talented, nice, good people, and the wedding industry is so filled with that. And I don't know if you've ever been to, there's a conference called Engage, which
okay.
is a big kind of wedding industry, luxury wedding industry conference. And it is literally, when you go back, it is like going back to camp. Everyone's hugging each other, and also competitors. So planners with other planners, photographers with other
photographers.
So it's
flowers. A very collaborative industry.
I mean, I guess you have to be a good person to, you know, you have to like, you know, be chill to be, you know, in the wedding business, but it is a special business to be part of someone's life in this special phase and this special moment, and so many relationships are created. Philippe Chang, who's a photographer, just shot something for me recently, and he shot my rehearsal dinner, our wedding, you know, and there's so many great photographers. Do you know Donna Newman?
She's based
in Miami. Oh, you have to know
her.
She's amazing.
Donna Newman.
She's amazingly talented. Once again, I have to have someone hand me my bag. Where is it? I'll jump up and get it. Thank you. This is okay. So thank you so much. Okay, it's like overflowing with junk. But
this
is my bag that I carry of my kids. Everywhere.
So beautiful.
That I've been updating. I first did it with a wedding picture, then it moved on to my first daughter, my second daughter. She's been photographing, you know, my kids and in special occasions, and my oldest daughter just got bat mitzvahed last year. And we were saying, when you look back at these photographs, that, you know, life is, you know, as the last page of the book says, life is short, celebrate everything. And
I couldn't agree more.
So
tell us maybe about some of your favorite celebrations over the year and what made them stand out or feel special
to
you.
Well, of course,
the
party
while we chat.
Exactly. Okay, cheers.
The first toast
exactly.
So talk.
And, well, you know, I was just going to say, of course, the opening that I celebrated here was one of the top ones. But, you know, people say, like, what's your favorite party? What's the best wedding you ever have been in?
Right.
You know, duh. We're not in question is that?
And I online got, felt like I got to be at your wedding.
Oh, that's so funny.
Because I saw all of the amazing details.
Yeah, that's one of the nice things on Martha Stewart Weddings, or on our website, we have all the weddings and you can go back and
I can get lost there for hours.
I mean, honestly, so can I. And I was at them and I've seen them and I still love going through them.
Yes.
But I would say really, and this is not a pop-out answer, but it is hard to like say, oh, this was my favorite wedding or this was my favorite party. I mean, the book has some of my favorite ones, but obviously like the ones that are the most special to me are the ones for the people that I love. And I had a surprise party for my husband's 50th, and I had so many complicated lies going to keep this a surprise. And I first told him I was going to Martha's in Maine, because then I knew he would not be on a business trip. I was away because we try to not both be away at the same time. So it started with that, and then it moved on to, oh, it's going to be in New York, but I'm going to be gone all day, but there's a dinner have to go to. And then I had a friend who sent a fake email inviting him to something that night. And but I have to say, the best part of it was, it was filled with all these personal things, you know, and pictures of him from over party hats, and that were pictures of him from over the years. But the best part, honestly, was having this group of people and from different times of his life, from his childhood to, you know, college, graduate school, work, and everyone went around the table, you know, and said one thing that they loved about him. And, you know,
that's indelible.
And
you don't
those
forget
kind
that.
Of things are just, you know, kind of make occasions special.
So when you, so I understand it's hard to pick. When you're involved in Martha Stewart weddings, how do you pick?
Right.
Like how does a story come together to capture a wedding?
Well, we have an amazing, amazing group of talented editors, art director, stylists. Amy Conway, who's our editor-in-chief, and who's a longtime Martha editor, is amazing. And as I said, it's really a team of collaborative, smart, energetic workers who work together. And I have to say that it's a process, how it all happens. People do ask a lot, how you get your wedding in the magazine. And we have a real weddings editor named Shira Savada, who we have a bunch of submissions, a submission process, and we can go on the website. And, you know, we're always looking for different kind of weddings, different, you know, in different kind of locations, different traditions, different cultures. And some of them we actually send a photographer and shoot. Some of them we just pick up the pictures afterwards. And I think for me, that's one of my favorite parts of the magazine and the website, The Real Weddings. And, you know, it started so long ago. When we started, it was the second issue. The first issue was in 95. And in the very first issue, we said, okay, well, we're going to set up three weddings. And literally, we were in a studio in New York City, and we put up a tent, set table. It would look like for the country wedding. And then we're at the Burden Mansion, and we set it up like it was a wedding. I sugared so much sugared fruit, and we couldn't get into like midnight because we were using the location on Sunday. It was at an event there. I'll never forget. It was like my call time was like midnight to like load in so we could shoot Sunday morning. And after that, we're like, maybe we should shoot real people's weddings. They're creating these.
But so that's the evolution.
And then it just grew, you know. One of the first ones was a Daisy wedding, and the bride, who actually owns a store, Pearl, which is an amazing knitting store down in Soho.
Oh,
and it's
I've
a beautiful
heard of
website.
Pearl. Yes,
her
yes,
name
yes.
is Paige. Actually, she's partnered with Joelle, who's also a Martha alumna.
Okay. What a network to be a part of.
I know, there's a lot of talented people. It is like, you know, I always thought after I went to University of Pennsylvania and I was like, oh, maybe I'll go to graduate school, but I think that working at Martha Stewart was the ultimate graduate graduate school.
I couldn't think of another school to go to.
I can't even begin to list, but there's two great resources for paper flowers. One woman's name is Rebecca Thus, and she has a paper flower book, and one is Livia Chetty. She's a business called The Green Vase. I mean, do you know Confetti Systems? They make amazing pinatas, amazing garlands and pinatas.
Darcy, we're going to need a whole other session for all of the resources. Like, but you know what we'll do? If you have any questions at home about specific advice or resources, Darcy, maybe you can answer those questions.
Happy to.
And share.
If you're looking for something, if you're looking
secrets.
For the right paper flowers, or but that is, you know, a lot also in the book and in the magazine and on the website. A lot is sharing kind of your, you know, information, your sources. You know, on my Instagram, I always like to share.
Which
actually,
I
someone
love.
Just sent me some really cute cookies. I have to take a picture. I'm going to post them today from a new cookie maker who I do not know. But I always love
discovery,
and I think that that's part of being my experience as an editor, and as something that I always, you know, grew up doing, which is finding the bead store, finding, you know, the perfect ribbon.
Well, it's very special, I think, for us at Flushington. We're so passionate about what we're doing, and to see your career and to get a little window into how you turned your passion into an entire career. And that's just, I think, an amazing inspiration for everyone at home to follow that passion, to pursue it, and see, is this something you'll enjoy in your personal life, or is this something that can become a business and even
a book? And I have to say, I think part of it's always not always so easy to figure out what you like to do and what the job is.
Not.
And when I graduated from Penn, which is, you know, University of Pennsylvania, a lot of my friends who graduated were, you know, on a more direct career path. They wanted to be a lawyer, so they were a paralegal, or they wanted to, you know, and I was like, well, I'm creative. What does that mean? I love art, but I don't necessarily want to work in the, you know, at a museum or the art world. And so, it was like a little struggle to figure what that was. And I graduated from college and I lived at home with my parents. And I just
Which is all the rage right now, by the way.
And not that I'm putting that down, because I have the coolest, most awesome parents. And I will say that I don't have to worry about what time I came home at night, because my parents stay out later than I do.
I will attest to their coolness.
Exactly. You probably see them out all the time.
They're the most dapper couple.
Yeah, they're very
hip. And so in love.
Yes, they.
Which is so nice to see.
Very special. But I basically just like reached out to people and offered if I could intern, volunteer. I did windows at Bloomingdale's. I had this party favor business that I did on the side to make some money. I worked in the kitchen at a corporate place to get, you know, some entertaining experience. I worked for Robert Isabel, just, you know, picking thorns off roses, you name it. And so, you know, and not that I've reached it now. I'm always figuring it out. I think everyone's always figuring it out.
But
you know,
that's
it's a process,
truly, and it's a journey.
Right.
And there is no, you figure it out maybe for the moment, and then there's the next phase of the journey and more learning and figuring out and discovery. So Darcy, we can't thank you enough for coming today.
Well, thank you, and I'll have to say I feel honored to have been asked to do this. And when you were just before, well, full disclosure, I had my makeup done before, which is why
you look amazing.
I didn't look like this when I walked in the door. But, you know, it's so nice, as I said, whether it's in the celebrations industry, the wedding business, to discover great businesses that are great resources. And I was saying to you, to all my wedding planner friends and people in the party industry, this is such a great resource
company.
And so I'm incredibly impressed, and I feel like I need to come back tomorrow and the next day, I'm coming after we turn this off. I'm going for a makeup lesson.
Well, we love you have carte blanche every day. We look forward to your visit, and Thank you, everyone at home, for joining us on Blush Talks. We'll be sure to answer all of your questions. So, as